Hi guys, my name is Vlad. Today I will be looking at the iPhone 7 that is dead. When I plug the cable on the ammeter, it takes 0.33 milliamps, like 0.330 milliamps. Okay. So let's move to this camera. We'll plug in the cable and see if that's correct. If there is any change from the time I tested that. Yeah, the phone takes 330 milliamps, and there is completely black screen, nothing at all. All right, so let's disassemble the phone and see what's happening there. Okay, board is out for this phone. Let's connect it to the power supply and see what we are getting there. And I have a VDD main short of 1 amp. Let's take it out. I'm getting something here. Let's see. That doesn't look too bad. Let's remove that sticker anyway. Let's check for some water damage. No, phone is very clean. We don't have any water damage. We have some kind of a thing here. Position around here. Yeah, I press it slightly and we're getting in that area. I don't know if you can see that on the video, but we have now no lights there, and I press it there, we're getting the splash. Yeah, supposed to be able to see. Okay, let's take it out. Let's remove that component and see. Okay, let's add a little bit of flux. 340 degrees. See if our short is gone. Next, connect power supply. Oh, my power supply cable broke. Look at that. Oh. Let's see if I can fix it quickly. Let's see if I can fix it. Is it like that? Yeah, looks like that. Or opposite. Probably opposite, as it's fitted nicely there. Let's add a little bit of flux. And let's reflow that. That will be fine. I think that's connected. At least most important parts connected. Let's see if it's work. I will plug in that back. And we still have the consumption. And if I pour the alcohol here, I think we will be able to see that that's that cup. Yeah. You see how that alcohol goes away? Let me zoom you in. Yeah, let's put a little bit of alcohol. You see? I'm pressing the button, it's straight away does this. Up, up, up. Yeah, that's enough. Let's remove that cup. Cup is out. Let's do a little bit of cleaning that area. Let's use a little bit more solder. Nice blob. A bit more flux, make a positioning better. Oh, that's excellent. Let's test again, by the way. Yeah, and we don't have now consumption, power supply is on. Okay, let's replace that component from another board. We don't actually need to replace cup, but I will do that anyway. This damage probably happened because of the human error, because that component, how it was damaged. It's impossible to happen by itself. So somebody was checking something and damaged that component. Component is out. Let's put it back there. It might be just slightly too much solder. Let's remove a bit. that should be okay. So you hardly can see, but that should be okay. I will make the pads better now. Okay, let's position the chip. Okay, let's take a cup now. Place cup back. That's okay. Let's clean area a bit. So be fine. Let's connect that to the power supply and confirm we don't have short. And you don't. That's good. Let's power the phone on. At least try. Let's try. I will take a housing. So the housing is here. Let's position the phone in, like motherboard in. Connect the screen. Let's take amp meter and see if we have any different consumption. Yeah, we have Apple logo. Looks like the phone charged battery enough to get a boot. Have a boot loop, yeah? No. We have vibration, phone came on, and we have passcode there from previous user. Okay. Let's see if we have the proximity. We have proximity, that means that audio is okay. Button works. Okay, let's connect phone to the computer and restore it via iTunes. It's stuck on this line like it has no IMEI number. But I saw before that it showed me no SIM instead of service. So it's not supposed to be an issue, but it's staying on that line very long. Yeah, we have no SIM, we have IMEI number, button works. Let's choose the country we are in. Wi-Fi is working. Touch ID don't work. Come on. If Touch ID don't work, I'm losing money again. So, let's see. Button works itself, but why we don't have Touch ID? Actual Touch ID sensor works, but for whatever reason we don't have Touch ID. At least I cannot register that. That's not good. Okay, let's test other functions. Camera works. Proximity works, we have a loudspeaker. Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Sound works, microphone works. Yeah, this phone is 32 gigabytes. Okay, what's left is to check why we don't have audio, or why we don't have the free fingerprint. Yeah, actual sensor works, but why we don't have fingerprint? Let's try to connect different screen, just in case. Hopefully that's a screen cable issue. This screen looks to be intact, so I connected the button to the other screen. Hopefully that will work. Let's connect the front camera as well, so we have proper light. Button works. This screen is water damaged. Let's see if Touch ID works. Yeah, Touch ID works. That's excellent. That means that I have to replace the screen. I'll check the battery. Battery is 92%. Yeah, so we'll change just a screen. So I will be back in a minute. Okay, let's see. And Touch ID. And Touch ID works. So the Touch ID works. I will end this repair here. Hopefully you liked the video, and see you next time.